That's how we start.
Okay. Now just read this.
Mm-hmm. Should I get scared or?
No.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Dr. Beeson.
You want me to do an accent or anything like that?
Yeah, whatever you're feeling. You're the talent.
It's sad.
There was an incident report file.
Oh.
Yeah. She was okay. I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
She was okay.
Oh. Okay. Night is yours alone.
When you're sure you've had enough. My patient in oral surgery kept complaining that she was in pain during an extraction. I told her we've given the maximum amount of anesthetic and she'd have to suck it up because I was too scared to admit to Dr. Williams I missed my third block. Cruel.
No, these are students.
Dr. McCarmel, what is happening?
Came back to my chair after grabbing a few supplies to find my patient breastfeeding her 18-month-old. Googled if there was a contraindication and started drilling.
Jesus.
After endo, a patient complained about bleach stains on her brand new sweater. I told her, that's so strange. You should be more careful mixing lights and darks in the washer. Been there, done that.
This is all wrong.
Dr. Markham completed my entire prep and then gave himself a 3.5 because he is so humble. He's a very humble man.
Oh, Dr. Markham is so nice.
I once informed a patient to wait 4 to 5 days to see if they would poop out a piece of tooth. I watched them swallow.
I rip open all new toothbrushes just so it looks like I gave OHI every time. There is no doubt in my mind that happens every day.
You got something written wrong here.
We got some, yeah, we got some spelling.
It's terrible.
One time, the HVAC suction fell on the floor, and Radnicki picked it right back up and shoved it in the patient's mouth. Sounds like Radnicki.
That's so bad.
I once saw a professor pick up a Listerine bottle from the clinic floor, put it directly to her lips, take a swig, and set it back down. Did that seriously happen?
I once shotgunned a beer in the lobby of the new dental school to celebrate last year.
While irrigating with bleach, my patient immediately starts gagging and shouting, "What was that?" I said, must be something in the water. Good one.
Dr. Kearney once made me do a pin-retained amalgam buildup on a tough patient. So I laid out a triturator cord trap in my operatory. Yes, indeed. That's a true confession I can attest to.
Occasionally I use the HVAC to dissipate a fart, but don't have time to leave the chair.
Can't believe I have to redo your stuff for you.
I took final impressions of a complete denture on June 26th and poured them up August 13th. The patient couldn't stop raving about them. It's pretty good.
In Boyne, there was all sorts of stuff in the hallway that said, "Property of Dr. Wilwerding." There was a long, narrow table that would have been perfect for beer pong. So I had no choice but to steal it one night. Sorry, Dr. Wilwerding.
I wondered where that table went.
All right. I'm in love with Dr. Mardini, so sue me. Why? I think it's a good thing. That's my favorite one.
I only clean operatories when there's blood spatter. So routinely.
Interesting.
I once shotgunned a beer in the lobby of the new dental school to celebrate our last year. I can get it.
I was diligently working on my first denture case and had my Bunsen burner going full blast in the operatory when the patient gets up to use the sink and catch her entire sleeve. something on fire. She went to the ER, but I told her it happens all the time. That's so bad.
Obviously, they're not English majors.
Cut.
Oh, I read that one.
Not even a comment.